Hey friends, did you know that you can query data modeled in JSON documents using SQL? Tim is here to show updates on how the rich query and indexing functionality of Azure Cosmos DB's SQL API can give you the best of both worlds, NoSQL and relational databases, today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, it's Azure Friday, and our good friends from the Azure Cosmos DB team are here. Tim, I love that Cosmos DB comes on Azure Friday all the time. Correla comes on all the time, and what's great is that you're going to tell me what's new right now in Cosmos DB, because you all add features and make things better so fast. It's so cool. What is new right now, querying and indexing?
We do, and I think I want to start. I think Kirill from my team was on the show a little while ago, and he showed aggregate perf improvements in Azure Cosmos DB. Mm-hmm. I'm pleased to say that these have been rolled out to all new accounts in Cosmos DB. So definitely check these out. Mm-hmm. They're really awesome.
Make sure that you go back on Azure Friday and look at all the great Azure Cosmos DB content. There's mm-hmm. a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah, so today I want to focus on some awesome new query features that we've released in our SQL API.
Okay.
The first thing I'm going to talk about are how you can use composite indexes to optimize order by queries in Azure Cosmos DB. Mm-hmm. So I have a quick demo prepared that I want to show to talk about that.
Let's do it.
If you look at this query here, it's doing a filter on a nutrition data set that I have. This is a data set of many different food items and has things like tags for the name of the food items, categories for them, food groups, and then more information about their nutrition content.
Is that group there that says this, comma, is that treated as something special with the commas and the mm-hmm. and, or is that a string query, or what's happening
yeah,
there?
Yeah, so right here in this query here, I'm doing a filter where the food group is equal to soups, sauces, and gravies.
Okay.
And then I'm doing an order by the timestamp. Underscore TS is just a system property in Cosmos DB for the timestamp.
Okay, cool.
Now, this collection that I have right here just does the default Cosmos DB index set. It has a range index on every single property.
Okay.
And when I run this query, it's pretty efficient. It uses about 21 RUs. Okay. But we can optimize this.
Okay.
If we add on a composite index, we can have the query go and use the composite index for the order by instead of using the range indexes.
And RUs are important to remember for people who may not be familiar, is because it speaks to capacity and what you paid for. So the lower that is, the more you can get done.
Absolutely. So this query used about 21 RUs. If I come here and add on a composite index, I'm going to scroll down to the bottom of the indexing policy and just add a composite index on those two properties. If I save that and then come back to the original query and just do a small modification on the query text to tell it to use the composite index to filter on the food group and then do an order by timestamp, when I run that, I go all the way down to 4 RUs. So this is a lot more cost effective because I got about a 5 or 6x perf improvement. So for every one time I ran that earlier query, I could run the same query 5 times, and the cost would be the same, and the performance will also be much faster.
You did that index addition pretty quickly. Would you mind going back and showing the JSON at the
bottom
there?
Yeah, absolutely. So what I've done here is added on a, zoom out a bit.
There we go, line 14. So you've got composite indexes, and you added it within that JSON expression, that declarative expression of mm-hmm. what the indexings are.
That's exactly right. I chose to add it through the portal here, but this is supported in our SDKs as well. You could add them in through that.
Mm-hmm. And now you said that just made that 5 times effectively more efficient.
Exactly right. And this was, the crazy thing is, this was only a 64 megabyte data set. So this is a tiny, tiny scale. Of course, if you did this on a much larger scale, the perf improvements would be incredibly significant.
Wow. So you could get, you know, with a smart composite index, you can get an order of magnitude more perf.
That's exactly right. So the idea is, for most queries, your range indexes that are created by default are going to be awesome. But if you want even better performance for queries that have order bys, composite indexes are a really great fit.
Okay. And then my question is going to be, how do I know to do this? And I'm going to guess I know the answer is test it, try it out, measure.
Absolutely. So it's all about your query patterns. We've put this in our indexing docs, so take a look there. We've highlighted the key use cases where you want to use composite indexes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's a great demo on how to use composite indexes to make a lower RU charge.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What's our next demo?
Yeah. So the next thing I want to talk about is subqueries in Azure Cosmos DB.
Okay.
Subqueries make it a lot easier to work with arrays in Cosmos DB. In Cosmos DB, you can model your data in JSON. And a great advantage of JSON is you can have arrays in your data, and this gives you tons of data modeling flexibility.
And that's definitely something that, when the context of a relational data, of an entity, you know, an ER diagram, mm-hmm. it's kind of hard to express. Like it's effectively kind of like a subtable with a join back, but within the context of JSON, it's just really just an array of stuff.
Absolutely right. You get tons of flexibility with modeling data, and it makes use cases like that really simple to model in Cosmos DB.
Cool.
So subqueries make it really simple to work with arrays when you're querying data. So I'm going to show off another demo where I'm running a subquery that uses the same data set and basically does a self-join between the different arrays in my data set. In this nutrition data set, I have tags for different names of food items, nutrients, and servings arrays. And essentially what this query does is it does a join between these different arrays within the same document and then applies filter logic on them. Now, when I run the query this way, it's doing the filters after I've done the joins between the arrays. So the RU charge is actually pretty high.
Wow.
It's over 100 RUs.
Okay, so that was kind of a big deal. I mean, you got three self-joins and a fairly sophisticated where clause. And by default, it just does the best it can.
Yes, exactly right. And before we had subqueries, this was really the best way to have a filter like this with properties within arrays. Now, if I rewrite this query using a subquery, I can do subquery logic before I actually join the different arrays.
Okay, so you're still doing the three joins, but you're filtering before the join happens.
Exactly right.
As opposed to after the fact.
So if there were, let's say, 10 elements in each array, in the absence of doing a subquery, I'd be doing 10 times 10 times 10 different combinations. I think that's
three orders of magnitude.
Three orders of magnitude. It's a really big number, and this really doesn't scale very well. When I use a subquery here, we're only joining the array elements that match this subquery's filter.
Well, and frankly, it's actually a cleaner looking query as well.
Really easy to understand, and when I run it, RU charge is much lower. It's only about 16 RUs.
Wow, so almost 10x.
Exactly.
So here you are with something that's three orders of magnitude of complexity. You just got a free order of magnitude right there, and now you can do this query 10 times for the same price.
Exactly right. And another key thing to emphasize is these were pretty small arrays. This would be much more powerful if I had very large arrays and maybe a filter that only matched a few different elements within it.
So this simple, in quotes, thing, if someone's watching this and they do Cosmos DB, hopefully they're going to just be thrown back in their seat and say, oh my goodness, I can be a hero at work right now. I'm just going to go and factor that one query that everyone hates into using subqueries, and I'm going to be a hero for at least an hour.
That's exactly right. It's going to be simpler, latency is going to be lower, and the cost will ultimately be lower.
You can get a promotion with Cosmos DB today, my friends. Okay, cool. So what other cool subqueries can we do?
Yeah, so one other cool use case of subqueries that I want to show off are how you can rewrite array contains to use a subquery.
Okay.
So right here, I have a query that I'm going to run that uses the array contains system function. What array contains does is this query is going to return all documents where the tags array had at least one name that was orange. So when I run this query, it's returning documents whose tags array contained orange, essentially, as a name. I can rewrite this using...
How long many RUs did that use, if you don't
know? Oh, yeah. So the RU charge was pretty low. It's about... Run that again. It's just about three RUs.
Okay, that's not bad.
Yeah. So when
pretty simple.
Very, very simple. Yeah. So when I do this query using a subquery and I run it, I've rewritten the query to use a subquery. Pretty similar RU charge, still about three RUs. But the key is since I've written it with the exists expression, instead of being restricted to an equality filter here, I can put in any subquery I want here. So it's much more expressive. If I wanted to have, let's say, a greater than or less than comparison, this is ideal for that.
That's a really great point, because I was thinking about RUs, but in this example, we've got a situation where for the exact same price, we get a much more expressive and easier to read query, and it opens up a whole new series of filters that we could go and put within that subquery.
That's exactly right. It's just
and
much more expressive.
And costs us nothing different.
Exactly.
That's cool. So are these just things that I just have? Did I just wake up this morning and I have these features?
Yeah, so we released both of these features at build. So they've been actually available for quite a few months now. What's new is a lot of the new use cases for composite indexes in Cosmos DB. But both of these features are available in all our SDKs, and actually for subqueries, you don't even need to do anything special with indexing.
Okay, so I don't have to go and update my indexes like you did at the beginning for the subquery stuff, and then for the composite index, once I can do that, I do some measuring and some testing and some measuring and some testing, I'm going to be able to tune the heck out of my databases.
Exactly right.
Hey, that's pretty sweet.
So in addition to all those awesome new query functions we have, and query functionality, indexing functionality, we also have a ton of additional features that we're releasing now in Azure Cosmos DB as well. We're releasing support for group by, which is a really awesome way to, again, improve our SQL query functionality within the product and give you the best of both worlds between relational and NoSQL databases.
Mm-hmm.
We also definitely want you to explore our Cosmos DB notebooks, which I believe you had a show a few weeks ago on mm-hmm. that, so I definitely recommend reviewing that show to learn more about that. And we're also pleased to announce support for MongoDB's 3.6 wire protocol available in Cosmos DB collections as well.
Fantastic. The hits keep on coming with great new features in Azure Cosmos DB. I've been learning all about what's new with querying and indexing today on Azure Friday.